Okay, has a lot of armor. Let's take it away. Fuck. It was a bad miss. Really? Fuck it. 8% that I missed. Wow, game. Thankfully, I missed in my favor. Don't fucking miss again. Good. You know what? Do this. Take this. I'm going there, right? Yeah. Run. Run, run, run away. Can stop the virus level and then you can kill them. What's happening? I can't see. Alright, and now we'll just clean up. Kill me. Let's see, 2 body, 1 strength, 1 willpower. Yep. And do I see any enemies? Where the fuck did that enemy go? I'm not sure. Alright. 9 84. Enough ammo. Fine. The nice. Now that he is. What the? Okay. Guy wants to come close. Fine. Wow. Nope, of course. Why? I just want to hit that. Because fuck you, that's way. I really, really hope they fix that shit. It's annoying as hell. Yes, heal yourself. Do it. Good job. Nine damage, really? Can't actually see. We'll go close. One more person. Exterminate. Nice. Alright, that wasn't so hard actually. Yep. Weird. Anyway, let's save. And talk to the orc. The burly orc's face, raw and sleek with scar tissue, is contorted in a grimace of pain. You've seen this kind of wound before. He doesn't have long. Idiots. 40 years. 40 years and we finally had a chance to make a difference. And you blew it. Odran's eyes go wide as you reach for his weapon. He tries to bat your hands away, but the weight of coughing sends him to a fit. A bloody mist fills the air. You level the weapon and he thrusts in panic. Yep. Nope, I don't care what the fucking point was. Put a bullet in his head. Fucking madman. There was something to jack in here. Didn't notice. Doesn't matter anyway. Alright, let's see. Can we talk to the dragon? Maybe we need to first combine their spirits. The gaunt woman stares wide-eyed as you approach. She presses one hand to the wall of her glass prison, closes her eyes, and mouths one word. Please. The console next to the containment cell appears to control a variety of functions related to the cell's operation, including its life support systems. Next to it is a small intercom button. Speak to them. A green light activates inside the containment cell, and the gaunt woman flinches up at it, startled. Then understanding appears on her face and she begins to speak, her eyes flashing from her dragon body then back to you again and again. Close now, so close. The elf has done what has been done. The longest flight, nears its end. She is so close, so very close now. She stops suddenly, her eyes taking the devices surrounding and invading the dragon's body. The tubes of viscous yellow liquid running into it. The monitors flashing their status. Recognition and horror explodes onto her face. and she screams a long mournful wail. Bonclair, no, no, defiled, I am defiled. Her face contorts in a mask of fury and her mouth opens wide, wider than should be possible. Her neck cranes towards forward and her head swings from side to side as she hisses in rage. Wow, okay. She slathers, her spittily hitting the glass between you as she speaks. Despoiler, peasant, vermin, pig dog. He dares touch my sacred me. Shall rend him, flay him, burn him, burn. Us, nothing left but us. Wow, she's fucking crazy. Okay. She stands there, panting for a moment, spent. Then her eyes narrow, focus, eyes over. It will be slow, Beauclair. I will make it slow, delicious. Beauclair is dead, Father Wingale. The gaunt woman breathes a ragged breath, releases it slowly. When she speaks again, her voice is flat. Will you release me now, elf? Make me whole again? Whole? Maybe, but you need to answer some questions first. You dare? No, no, ask. Ask your questions, little elf, so I may escape this cage. The long sleep awaits, the long flight will finally end. Why did you do it? Why kill all those people? The gaunt woman covers her mouth with her hand, a look of horror in her eyes. You did do it, right? You burned thousands of people to death. She glares at you over her hand, nods her head yes. Burned. Burned, 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 yes. Also cold. I walk to the cold, the grey. Where is the green, elf? Where is the green? What is the green? The mother. The mother lost. What have they done, little elf? What have they done? I guess she was pissed because the humanity had pretty much destroyed nature. How do I know you won't hurt anyone else? Swear it. Father Winge will swear it. Very well, then swear it. Swear, yes, swear, swear to hurt no man, no beast, no tree, no crop, no building. Father Wunge will fly to the long sleep until the next age of the world. For the forever task, the shelter, the shield, the shepherd. What? Sacred, it is a sacred, it is forever task. Now let me go or end me, but release me, release. Use astral perception to read the Herora, sure. Your third eye slides open, revealing the tubes and machinery of Von Clare's infusion member as a cold dead grey. You look to the right, to the beast entangled to the cold nest of metal and plastic. Although it still glows with life, you note that the aura radiating from the dragon's body is damaged, sickly, dull. Your gaze is drawn to the left, to the woman trapped in the cold hard cell. A heart's white light blazes from her aura, temporarily blinding you, causes shimmering blue globules to dance before your eyes. Phoenix, can you hear me? I think she's gone bye-bye. It takes time, but you focus past the glare of her aura, to see the swirls of black and sickly green, snaking through Father Winger's astral form, cutting swaths of shadow into her light, spilling it backwards into nothingness. Your hand slowly drifts up on its own accord, reaches out, touches the aura glowing through the grey of the containment cell. What's it doing? Seeing the truth, I think. The all-encompassing cold hits you like a sledgehammer, and your mind is overloaded by the ordeal. Awakening, eyes opening for the first time in an age. A spectrum of colors is beautiful, broader than humanity can imagine. Astral and physical space are one to you, and the green is alive, waiting to show you its growth during your long sleep. The nest has served its purpose, and you leave it behind, taking to the air, exalting the flex of your muscle, the spread of your wings, the wind on your scales. As you soar over the mountains, even older than you, the memories come flooding back, wheeling in the sunshine, basking in the sun, the smell of the green, the sounds of nature's symphony. Your heart fills with the thought. And then it is torn apart. You smell it first, and the sting of it chokes you, makes you retch, and then you see it, as far as your keen eye can reach. Human stone and metal, glass and flickering lights, sprawled across the land, slashing to the sky, lording over it, smothering the whole of the world. Dead, colorless, without connection, nature's graveyard. You ride the headwind, hovering in space, as the world stops. You crash your eyes closed, and when they open again, you can see only one color, red. The vision ends and your connection to Fuzzer Winkers' astral form is broken. You woke up to find your world destroyed, didn't you, Fuzzer Winker? We killed the green. The gaunt woman stops her pacing and her eyes slowly rise to meet yours. Lucid, unblurred by time or torture or separation from her body. When she speaks, her voice is flat. Yes, gone, all gone. The cult has won, the world is metal. Fuzzer Winker is lost. You're not lost, you said you would begin again, remember? That is the eternal task, yes, to sleep the long sleep, begin again the next stage of the world. She wraps her arms around herself, quietly shivering. Lost, Fuzzer Winker is lost. There will be no long slumber. The world is dead now. Fuzzer Winker is dead. She looks at you sadly, longingly. Will you finish it, little Leif? Will you end Fuzzer Winker? No, Fuzzer Winker, a forever task requires patience and faith. The next world could be better. I have been ripped from my body, little Leif. Imprisoned in this girl, imprisoned in this cage, tortured longer than the span of your entire lifetime. And I have been defiled. The green is defiled, spoiled. There is no forever for me. Forever is dead. I do not want to sleep the long sleep. I want oblivion. End me, little Leif. The green needs you, Fuzzer Winker. You are her shelter, her shield, her shepherd. Don't abandon her. I cannot abandon what does not exist. The green is gone. The cult has won. No, the cult hasn't won. Don't forget the elves. They still tend the green. Her brow furrows and her head is stingy of stingy hair inclines. The elves? Yes, look at Tirna Nog. They turn Girn, yes, I'm butchering these names, but whatever. The Tirn Gire, elven city is devoted to the green, to keeping it safe. Her eyes widen as the memories return. They would build walls around it, as before. The green still lives, Fuzzer Winker. He holds her hands in her hand. It lives. You are Fuzzer Winker. While you live, the green will live. The gaunt woman pulls herself to her full height. Speaks as if to herself. While the green still lives, the task remains. Until the last world ends. The vessel holding the dragon lifts her face to the sky. She cannot see. Perhaps it is not too late. Sleep. Sleep will bring healing. My nest. Her fragile form trembles, but she steadies herself. When she speaks, again her voice is calm, at peace. If you release me, little Leif, I will sleep the long sleep. I will begin again in the next stage of the world. Allow her to return to her body. Sleep well, Fuzzer Winker, and goodbye. The gaunt woman drops to her knees, her face reflecting a series of emotions. Surprise, relief, appreciation, and finally peace. Then the light exits her eyes and she falls to the floor of her tiny cell, her body limp and lifeless. For a long moment nothing happens. Then without warning the entire chamber fills with a blinding light. You can see nothing, all goes eerily quiet. And yet somewhere, just at the edge of your hearing, you think you can recognize the faint whispering of voices, the sound sad and far away. Just as you think you might discern the voices, there is a massive crash, and the entire chamber starts to shake. Disoriented, you stagger for several moments, still blinded and trying to recover. That was pretty fucking awesome. Alright, you steady yourself and your senses return in time to see the faint form of the dragon disappearing in the distance. The Fuzzer Winker is gone. We just released a great dragon. An insane great dragon. She has a point, Phoenix. What Von Clair did to Firewing was wrong, but I don't know if that justifies setting her free. Lord knows what she's going to do now. I'm not sure I would have made the same call. Oh, come on, Iger. How many other people can say that they've released a captive dragon to the wild?